He's Kevin and I'm Eric, and we're looking at week one of the preseason. A couple interesting themes that developed, one of which I thought was the rookie quarterbacks. It was interesting to see all those guys representing their new teams. Cam Newton, his numbers weren't that great, but he played pretty well in the preseason opener against the Giants. And two rookies squared off in New England last week. It was Blaine Gabbert for the Jaguars and Ryan Mallett, maybe the surprise star for the Patriots.
Yeah, Gabbert got the start because David Guard's hurt, so you know Jaguars got an early look of the future. And you know he did fine for his first preseason game. Again, keep in mind, these guys have only had a little over a week with these playbooks because of the lockout. Ryan Mallett, though, talk about going into that Patriots complex offense. A lot of questions about Mallett. You know, he slid down in the third round, and he looked very impressive in his first start.
Yeah, the arm strength obviously impressive, but the way he kind of handled the situation caught me off guard. I was impressed with his poise. A couple of the guys who didn't look bad. Jake Locker had a nice throw or two in the game. Christian Ponder, they faced off against each other. I thought both of them did fairly well. Two guys who struggled, Andy Dalton with the Bengals. Look, he's got a poor team around him right now. He's just trying to figure things out. And Colin Kaepernick looked like he was a little behind the ball with the 49ers, maybe why they're looking at Dante Culpepper. Now, Kevin, I want to ask you about a game you attended, the Bears-Bills game in Chicago. Every team with the new kickoff rule now is kicking off from the 35. Every team except the Bears, that is, the first two kickoffs of the game at the 30. Tell me about that story.
Well, it was kind of hard to realize it because we're so used to them kicking off from the 30, but what happened was they had already gotten permission from the officials before the game, and what are the officials going to say? Fine, it's, you know, technically you're at a disadvantage if you kick from the 30. So they went ahead and did it twice. The Bills were okay with it, but then the league office was not happy about it, and Lovie Smith said, look, I got to get my guys some practice. You know, when you're looking at the preseason, you're trying to separate guy number 53 from 54. These are the coverage guys. Or the guys blocking and returns. These guys need some opportunities, and I kind of like that Lovie gave him a chance and tweaked with the rules a little bit, whether or not the league office liked it, you know. So what? That's the way Lovie saw it. Yeah. Again, give these guys an opportunity.
Probably won't happen in the regular season games. We'll see. Sean Merriman, real quick on the Bills, obviously looked like he was a little more active than we expected. What did you see from him in the opener?
We had back-to-back sacks. I mean, he was playing like this was a regular season game. In fact, left tackle for the Bears, Marcus Webb, said that. Merriman came with an intensity he couldn't match. And you know, Merriman looked like it had evolved. Again, preseason against the Bears offensive line, you got to take that with a grain of salt. But if you're a Bills fan, you have to be happy because the pass rush hopes are on.
And talking about comeback stories, I thought Matthew Stafford threw the ball really well against the Bengals. We're expecting a big season out of him. Hopefully he can stay on the field for 16 games. Look, it was only 1 week of the preseason, but a lot of information was found. You can also get a lot of information about the 2011 season at ProFootballWeekly.com. Check out our season preview downloadable form right now.